Hey everyone, Dr. Luke Peterson here, physical therapist with the Knee Replacement Therapist. For this episode of the Knee to Know Show, we're going to talk about low back pain and what are some of the potential reasons that you might have low back pain after knee replacement surgery. Hey everyone, so for today's episode, we're going to talk about low back pain after knee replacement surgery. And in particular, we're going to talk about what are some of the potential reasons why you might get back pain after surgery, and why is it so prevalent and so common to see people who go through the knee replacement process, but then after surgery, they are experiencing a new thing, low back pain, possibly some sciatica. What is going on? Why might this be going on? So the first thing I want you to think about is think of the body as an interconnected chain. So basically, if you think about a chain and the links in a chain, and if one link in that chain is broken or twisted or knotted, it's going to affect the integrity and how the movement is of the entire chain. And so if you think about your body like a chain, and your knee is one link in that chain, and it has been changed because of knee replacement surgery. Initially after surgery, it might be very stiff, very painful. There might be some range of motion limitations. You might not be able to move it as much. You'll have some muscle weakness in the muscles of your thigh and quadriceps. And that chain in the that link in the chain has been affected. And so what's going to happen is it's going to affect other parts of your body up and down. It's going to affect what's going on in your calf and your foot and ankle. It's going to affect what's going on in your hips and pelvis and your low back. And the main thing is there's going to be different stresses, different forces that these areas are going to deal with. You're going to be moving differently. You're going to be walking differently. And your body overall has to adapt more or less to these new forces that they're experiencing. So that's one reason potentially why you might have some back pain. Other things to think about is the actual knee replacement surgery. So one thing, you're getting an injection typically in your low back, your anesthesia for pain relief to help you have the surgery, potentially most likely into your low back area. You're spending a prolonged period of time, although you're unconscious in most instances, your body is spending a prolonged period of time laying on a surgical table with your knee up in the air, probably a little bit awkward, not most common, most comfortable position to be laying in. And so that is some new stresses and something different that your low back is experiencing and dealing with. Some other things to think about is immediately after surgery, some of the things you're going through in that acute phase. One of them is you're probably not moving around as much. You're sitting in bed, you're sitting in the recliner, you're probably not getting up and moving. So that immobility for a long time, your muscles aren't contracting, you're not getting blood flow, you're not getting oxygen to those tissues as much. And then when you're sleeping, you know, how many people have really tough times sleeping after knee replacement surgery? You're probably in positions that you don't normally sleep in. You might be on the recliner sleeping. You might have your leg propped up on all these pillows. And you're just going to have difficulty sleeping in general. And so you're going to be moving around a lot and just not in a comfortable position. And so that's another thing to consider. And then you also just want to think about, you know, what happens to the knee after surgery. Possibly before surgery, you had rounded knees or bow-leggedness. Possibly you had knock knees. And there might have been some other sort of impairments, alignment concerns before your surgery. And when you had knee replacement surgery, hopefully your surgeon did their best to realign things, fix things up, help the anatomy and physiology of the knee joint itself. And so though this is a beneficial thing, think about how much of a difference that makes in how you're moving, how you stand, how you're walking, and all these factors are contributing to different stresses, different movements on your body. And the other thing you want to think about is, you know, just what are your expectations? What is your psychological, mental mindset? You know, if you're someone who's had knee replacement surgery and you're ready to get back to feeling better and doing the things you enjoy, and then all of a sudden your body gets hit with this low back pain or this sciatica, you're gonna feel that a little bit and you're gonna be frustrated, and you might, you know, start to pain catastrophize. You might start to emphasize and increase and exaggerate how much discomfort and pain and how debilitating it really is. So you want to take that step back, see things from a bird's eye view a little bit, and realize, okay, you know, I'm really frustrated about this right now, but you know, back pain is common. Probably most of us have had back pain before surgery, and it's something that it comes, and a lot of times just with time and maybe a little bit of physical therapy or a little bit of exercise or a hot pack or stretching or whatever it may be, it tends to alleviate over time on its own. So there's no reason to suspect that this occurrence is not any different than those times. Some instances it is, it's a little bit more chronic, might take a little longer, but there's no reason to believe that it's going to be any increased risk of that being the case. So all these things together can help give you a better idea of why having low back pain and discomfort, having hip pain, whatever it may be, is prevalent, is common, is normal after knee replacement surgery. Is it the end of the world? No. A lot of people will have it, and a lot of times it will start to alleviate and it will feel better and it will get better. Sometimes for some people it takes a little bit more, takes a little bit more intervention, a little more management, but for the vast majority of people, it's able to, the symptoms are able to calm down, the pain's able to calm down, and you're able to feel better and continue with your recovery and get past that obstacle. So that's my spiel on why there's a lot of potential reasons that you may have back pain and why back pain is so prevalent after surgery. For tomorrow's video, I'm going to talk about why or what are some of my tips and tactics. What are some of my overall thoughts, overall principles when it comes to dealing with this back pain after surgery? So if you're someone who's interested in checking that out, be sure to stay tuned for tomorrow's video. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. Have a great rest of your day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.